Hello dear students, this is Daisy ma'am and as we have finished lesson 3 laws of motion, now we are going to start with the practice questions. So first we will start from the short answer type questions. So first question is, name the device used for measuring mass and weight. So the answer is, the device used for measuring mass is beam balance and weight is spring balance. Then second question, name a contact force which always acts perpendicular to the surface of contact of two objects. Answer is, normal force is a contact force which always acts perpendicular to the surface of contact of two objects. Question number 3, name a contact force which always acts tangential to the surface on contact and tends to oppose the relative motion between them. Answer is, frictional force. Question number 4, classify the following as contact and non-contact forces. A. A boy shooting an arrow from a bow is a contact force. B. A satellite revolving around the earth is a non-contact force. C. A speeding bike stops when its engine is switched off, contact force. D. High and low sea tides, non-contact force. Then comes question number 5. How does magnitude of non-contact forces depend on the distance between the two objects and how? Yes, magnitude of non-contact forces between two objects decreases on decreasing the distance between them. Next question number 6, which law of motion gives the definition of a force? Answer is, Newton's second law of motion. Question number 7, state Newton's second law of motion. Answer is, the second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is directly proportional to the applied unbalanced force and the change in momentum takes place in the direction of applied force. Question number 8, name the property of an object to resist a change in its state of rest or of uniform motion in a straight line. Answer is, it's the inertia of an object. Question number 9, if we quickly jerk a piece of paper kept under a book, the book does not move while. Answer is, this is because the book continues to be in its state of rest due to inertia. Question number 10. A sprinter is advised to reduce his speed slowly after completing his race. Why? Answer is, it is because when the sprinter suddenly comes to rest, his lower body comes to rest at once. But due to inertia of motion, his upper body is still in motion and it can make the sprinter to fall forward. Then comes question number 11. When a stone tied to a string is whirled in a horizontal circle and the string suddenly breaks, the stone flies off tangentially. Name the property for this observation. Answer 11. When a stone is going around a circular path, the instantaneous velocity of stone is acting as tangent to the circle. When the string breaks, the centripetal force stops to act. Due to inertia, the stone continues to move along the tangent to circular path. So the stone flies off tangentially to the circular path. Question number 12. Which one has greater inertia and why? A bicycle or a motorbike? Answer is, a body of larger mass has more inertia. Hence, a motorbike has more inertia than a bicycle. Question number 13. What will happen to the momentum of an object whose velocity is doubled? Answer is, momentum is directly proportional to velocity. If momentum of an object whose velocity is doubled, then its momentum doubles as well. Question number 14. On what factors does the momentum of an object depend? Answer is, momentum of an object depends on its mass and velocity. Question number 50. An object of mass small m is in a state of rest. What is its momentum? Answer is, let an object with mass small m is in the rest. Since object is in rest, therefore its velocity v is equal to 0. Now we know that momentum is equal to mass into velocity. Or momentum ka jo symbol hai wo hum p se denote karte hain. So p is equal to m into 0, that is equal to 0. Thus the momentum of an object in the rest, that is non-moving, is equal to 0. Question number 16. A bird hits the windscreen of a fast moving car and falls on the bonnet. Which of the two, the car or the bird, suffers greater change in momentum? Answer is, the bird will suffer more change in momentum. Question number 17. State Newton's first law of motion. Answer: Newton's first law of motion states that an object maintains its state of rest or of uniform linear motion unless compelled by some external unbalanced applied force. Question number 18. How is force related to rate of change of momentum? Answer: The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the force applied on it, and this change in momentum takes place in the direction of applied force. Question number 19. How is a Newton correlated to dyne? The relationship between a Newton and a dyne is 1 Newton is equal to 1 kilogram into meter second inverse 2, that is equal to 1000 gram into 100 centimeter second inverse. So that is equal to 10 to the power 5 gram centimeter second inverse 2, or 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne, or 1 dyne is equal to 10 to the power minus 5 Newton. So this is the answer or relationship. Question number 20. How does acceleration produced in an object depend on the external force acting on it? State the relationship. Answer is, according to Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma, where small m is mass of an object, which acquires acceleration small a when force capital F is applied on it. For a constant force, A is inversely proportional to the mass of an object. So A is inversely proportional 1 upon m. Or for a given force, acceleration is inversely proportional to the mass of an object. ठीक है, तो ऊपर जो equation लिखा हुआ है उसी का statement दिया हुआ है नीचे. Question number 21. Do action and reaction forces take place simultaneously or one after the other? Of course, action and reaction forces take place simultaneously. एक साथ ही ये अकर करते हैं. एक के बाद एक नहीं, जैसे action force लगेगा immediately reaction force भी लगता है. Question number 22. If a boy jumps on the sword out of a boat, the boat moves backward. Why? When a boy jumps on the sword out of a boat, the boat moves backward because he applies force on the boat, due to which boat moves backward. Question number 23. State the meaning of recoil velocity of a gun. Answer: Recoil velocity is a backward velocity experienced by a shooter when one shoots a bullet. Question number 24. How does a boatman row his boat in a river? Answer: To row a boat, the boatman pushes the water backward with the help of oars. This reaction force pushes the boat in forward direction. Question number 25. What is the basic principle on which a jet plane or a rocket works? Answer 25. A jet plane and rocket works on the same principle. They produce thrust through an internal pressure difference. Burning of fuel in a jet plane produces a large quantity of hot gases. These gases escape through a nozzle with a great force in backward direction. It is the action force. These hot gases in turn exert an equal force of reaction on jet plane, due to which the plane is accelerated in the forward direction. Question number 26. How does the gravitational force between two objects depend on the distance between them? Answer: If the distance between two given objects is doubled, the gravitational force between them is reduced to 1/4 of its original value. If the distance is tripled, then the gravitational force between them becomes 1/9 of its original value. Question number 27. Can gravitational force be repulsive in nature? No, gravitational force cannot be repulsive in nature. Question number 28. Two objects P and Q having masses m1 and m2, when separated by distance t, exert a force capital F on each other. What happens when the masses of both objects are doubled and distance between the two objects is reduced to half? Answer is, according to universal law of gravitation, the force of attraction between two bodies is F is equal to capital G m1 m2 upon r square. So when mass of both the objects are doubled, that is m1 dash is equal to 2m1 and m2 dash is equal to 2m2. So F dash is equal to G under bracket m1 m2 ki value likh denge, 2m1 2m2 upon r square is equal to kitna ho jayega, F dash is equal to 4F ho jayega, right? Multiply ho jayega. Thus gravitational force becomes 4 times. Then second case, when the distance is reduced to half, tab kya ho jayega, r dash is equal to 1/2. Then F dash is equal to G m1 m2 upon r square. Or second step mein dekhenge, G m1 m2 upon r अपॉन 2 होल स्क्वायर. ठीक है, क्योंकि यहाँ पे हम देख रहे हैं कि डिस्टेंस को रिड्यूस किया गया है. सो दिस विल बिकम 4gm1m2 upon r square is equal to 4f. Therefore, when the distance between the object is reduced to half, then the force of gravitation increased by 4 times from the original force. यानी कि अगर हम डिस्टेंस को कम कर देंगे तो अगर हम डिस्टेंस को हाफ रिड्यूस करेंगे तो जो उस पर ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स लगेगा वो 4 टाइम्स ज्यादा लगेगा उसके ओरिजिनल फोर्स के कंपैरिजन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 29, डज ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स बिटवीन टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स ओपे न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन गिव रीजन टू? आंसर इज येस, द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्सेज ओबे न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन। बॉडी, यहाँ पे एग्जाम्पल दिया हुआ, बॉडी ए अट्रैक्ट्स बॉडी बी विद अ फोर्स कैपिटल एफ बी ए एंड बॉडी बी अट्रैक्ट्स बॉडी ए विद अ फोर्स कैपिटल एफ बी ए। दीज टू फोर्सेज आर इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट, फॉर्मिंग एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन पेयर, हेंस ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्सेज ओबे न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन। देन क्वेश्चन नंबर 30, what happens to the gravitational force between two objects if the masses of both the objects are tripled and the distance between them is also tripled? यानी कि उनके masses भी tripled कर दिए जाए, उनके बीच में जो distance है उसको भी tripled कर दिया जाए। तो answer will be, the gravitational force between two objects if the masses of both the objects are tripled will be 9 times from the original value, and if the distance between them is also tripled then the gravitational force will be 1/9th time reduced from its original value. Question number 31, what is meant by acceleration due to gravity? Answer, whenever an object falls freely towards the earth, an acceleration is involved. As the acceleration is due to the force of gravity, the acceleration of a freely falling object is called the acceleration due to gravity. Then question number 32, an object is dropped from the top of a tower and it undergoes free fall. Write the equations of motion for the object. Equations of motion, that is initial speed u is equal to 0 होगी क्योंकि इसको drop किया जा रहा है. So इसकी जो equations होंगी that will be v is equal to gt, s is equal to half gt square and v square is equal to 2gs. Question number 33, write the equations of motion if an object is thrown in vertically upward direction. Answers, equation of motion if an object is thrown in vertically upward direction, that is equation 3. Three equations. First is v square is equal to u square minus 2gh. Second, v is equal to u minus gt. And third, h is equal to ut minus half gt square. यहाँ पे minus का sign तीनों equations में इसमें इसलिए show हो रहा है क्योंकि ये upward direction में जा रहा है, against the gravity जा रहा है, right? Then question number 34. Name any two gravitational units of force. How are they related to? Answer is, two gravitational units of force are Newton, SI unit, and dyne, CGS unit है, ठीक है, gravitational force की। then यहाँ पे हम इसका relationship देखेंगे, 1 Newton is equal to 10 की power 5 dyne और 1 dyne is equal to 10 की power minus 5 Newton. then question number 35, establish a relationship between 1 kilogram force and Newton. so answer is 1 kilogram force is equal to 1 kgf is equal to 9.8 Newton, which is approximately 10 Newtons, right? So this is the short answers. So you have to write all these answers in your copy and the messages. In the next video, we will talk about long answers.